The rise of terrorism led by the jihadist group Boko Haram in Nigeria, Chad, Cameroon and Niger has caused increased migration and an influx of refugees and internally displaced persons. Around 12 million people have been affected by insecurity since 2014 in these four countries. The violence has also weakened societies in the Lake Chad area, which are facing severe food insecurity, malnutrition, and health crises, including reduced access to sexual and reproductive health services. This region is a very complex one because of the recurrent chronic violence scenes which are prevailing here. These scenes of violence are partly due to some terrorist attacks from groups such as Boko Haram and partly by some confrontations between communities. Climate change plays also a role in it. It contributes to the dislocation of the society balance and affects the health and educational systems. The consequences are that populations move en masse to find places where there may be peace. The Lake Chad Basin is one of these places for these vulnerable populations. And because of climate change, this area is getting restricted because of these droughts. Some specialists say that the basin has lost 80% of its original surface, and this is accompanied by a demographic growth. In view of all these difficulties, the Lake Chad Basin region has called for a multisectorial and urgent response, as well as a comprehensive initiative to empower women, girls and youth to become active agents of change and development. For example, the Kingdom of Denmark and the United Nations Population Fund have launched a DK39 project which aims to strengthen the resilience of communities around Lake Chad through investments in youth and women in rural areas. The DK39 project, signed in December 2017, with a financing of $1,500,000, covers Niger and Chad. Indeed, the health indicators in Chad and Niger remain worrying, with high fertility rates between 4.5 and 7.5 children for each woman of childbearing age. Family planning services cover only 16 to 23% of the population, while more than 65% are under 25 years old. Niger and Chad also have one of the highest child marriage rates in the world, at 76% and 69% respectively.
L'origine de ce projet financé par le Royaume du Danemark.
The origin of this DK39 project financed by the government of Denmark comes from a whole reflection about our main domains of intervention with UNFPA in the Lake Chad Basin in order to guarantee the required needs of the populations in terms of maternal reproductive health and vulnerable population protection regarding the OVBG response.
OVBG, donc autour vraiment du Lac Chad.
Les populations les plus vulnérables, comme vous le savez, sont les femmes et les jeunes.
Women and youth are the most vulnerable populations, as you may know. The basic social structure were missing. There are no health centers, and the few which were here have been destroyed. The schools also are in the same situation, as you can notice that over the last years, many schools have been closed. Therefore, we made an advocacy and prepared a panel for needs. And when the Kingdom of Denmark saw it, decided to support Niger and Chad regarding the support to this.
The DK39 project, which aims to respond to the basic needs and challenges of displaced people in the Lake Chad region, is part of the African Union's drive to increase investment in youth. 21 months after its launch in Niger and Chad, it's time for an evaluation.
We
have had a retrospective of this project, which is taking an end very soon. And we noticed there is an impact as the results are very similar in each side of the border regarding the number of people who benefited from this project in terms of results, despite the difference of approaches. In Niger and Chad, there are some specificities that we put forward because it's important in order to have good results concerning this project.
Pour apporter des résultats sur ce projet.
C'est un projet qui a duré 21 mois.
This project lasted 21 months and consisted in an investment on women and youth for the Lake Chad Basin population's resilience. We have globally three targets, including a multifunctional center for an integrated care concerning gender-based violence, an integrated package of quality services such as maternal, neonatal and child health, and a psychosocial support and revenue-generating activities.
Et également des activités génératrices de revenus.
The two countries recently presented in Niamey the main achievements of the project for beneficiaries at a regional meeting on the implementation of evidence-based programs and knowledge sharing for scaling high-impact interventions in the Lake Chad Basin.
La première leçon que nous pouvons tirer.
The first lesson we can note in terms of success is that the project went far beyond our expectations. It reached four islands in the Chadian side, where there has never been social and community infrastructures, no schools, no health centers, no maternity wards. There was nothing. But thanks to this project, some services have been offered, and the process is still going on for the populations on these islands, which is now the home of more than 20,000 people.
Pas de maternité, à rien. Et grâce à ce projet,
and hopefully, we covered all the needs in terms of maternal health. In a context where the basic health needs used to be at 22% for deliveries, we have succeeded in taking care of 100% of the deliveries in those islands.
À peu près 20 000 habitants.
Pour citer des exemples avec des chiffres très concrets,
to give concrete examples with figures in terms of reproductive health, for a target of 35,000 people, the project reached 45,000 people, mainly on women and young girls, in terms of delivery, pre-delivery consultations, family planning, taking care of post-rape cases, and so on. So we certainly went beyond the targets of the project. The other aspect which concerns women's self-empowerment was solved by the revenue-generating activities that we initiated for them too, in order to allow them to take care of themselves. In DIFA, I can say that more than 200 women have been empowered with revenue-generating activities, be it in small-scale commerce, agro-transformation, or sewing, etc.
Transformation agroalimentaire, que ce soit des activités de couture, tissage, etc.
The UNFPA suggests that the positive impact of the DK39 project on people in Niger and Chad can be replicated in other countries in the Lake Chad region.
Concernant le Cameroun, bien sûr, on a appris beaucoup en termes de bonnes pratiques.
Concerning Cameroon, we learned a lot about good practices, but also in terms of lessons on things to take into consideration for many reasons. We work in an approach focused on women, youth and communities. It's the same populations who migrate from one country to another. And among the objectives of this project, there were the cross-border issues. That was very beneficial for our actions in Chad and for all the populations near the Lac Chad Basin and northern Cameroon, mainly everything which concerns peacekeeping and youth integration after conflict, women's support and gender-based violence, obstructive fistulas care, to name but a few. We really learned good practices from both countries as they focused their intervention on the communities. And these are certainly good experiences from which we'll learn.
C'est certainement des expériences sur lesquelles nous allons pouvoir apprendre.
At the regional meeting, the UNFPA's governments, civil societies, and UN agencies reaffirmed their commitment to oversee reproductive health and combat maternal and child mortality and fight against the violence that has caused displacement. These partners were not the only ones to have shown their commitment. Other local actors showed a desire to be more involved so that the tangible and innovative results obtained by the DK39 project can be better capitalized.
I think traditional chiefs have a big role to play to address the problem of early marriage, for education in healthcare, family planning, gender-based violence. These are current issues, and that's hopeful for countries around the Chad Lake to decide to unite their forces to arrest them and reach these targeted objectives.
At the end of the DK regional evaluation meeting for the DK39, it was agreed to establish and strengthen a platform for coordinating humanitarian interventions to share and replicate the good practices identified in Niger and Chad.